Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And I'm Pommi Henkka from Pommi Jätkä.
And today we have really exciting video. I think this is the most exciting explosion video in a while.
Yeah, it is.
We are going to make fuel air explosion. And all largest traditional bombs, like weapons, they are fuel air explosives. And we have already the device built here. We weren't able to make it as nice as the militaries around the world. We don't have the budget for that.
Unfortunately, yes.
But we have really nice city where we can test this.
Yeah, actually, that's right, because we done this 3 days. We have skyscrapers here, small houses, cars, and stuff like that. So we have really great demonstration area to know what thermobaric explosion will be.
And this video is sponsored by Timco Tools, and the city is built with Timco Tools.
Yeah, Timco Tools.
Yeah, let's see if it's going to be able to take the blast, but I think it's a bit unfair.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and now we are going to go back in time, because this is also one of the hardest things that we have ever done.
Yep.
This is third day when we like try to film this.
Yes, because this is really, really difficult to get success.
Yeah. So let's go back in time to see how difficult it is and how it actually works. The thing how this is going to work is that first we have explosives, like traditional explosion, inside of the fuel container. And it's going to spread the fuel into fine mist. And sometime after the first explosion, there's second one that's going to ignite the fuel mist. And it's going to be just right amount of fuel and air, so it's not going to burn, it's going to explode.
Yes,
or that's
right.
The goal.
And what is the delay between two explosions? That's the question.
Yeah. And to get that right, we are going to first try with water, we are going to explode this, and then we are going to check from the high speed how long it takes to get just right sized cloud. And then we are going to replicate the same with fuel and explode it away. And we are going to use biodegradable, non-toxic, flammable liquids today. So if it doesn't go, we are not going to like ruin the whole area.
Yes, because we like nature.
Yeah. I'm not sure does the nature like us, but we like nature.
Yes, we like earth.
And before we start, I want to remind that don't try to do this at home. You are not going to be able to make this. You still need high explosives for the first stage. And only thing that you are going to make is probably like huge mess or burn yourself with the fuel. So don't try this at home. And as you see, the water test went pretty well. The cloud was about right size that we wanted. So we decided to switch to fuel. And it didn't go well at all. On the first try, the starter detonation also ignited the fuel. And this is a good example of what we don't want to try here. Because this is like traditional gasoline pump, where the fuel just burns nicely. It looks pretty, but it like doesn't do anything. And when these work, they really do something, because there's much more energy on fuel than on explosives. Because on the explosives, you have like the oxidizer and fuel in the same place, but here we have just fuel and we take the oxidizer from the air, so in theory we have enough energy to make same sized explosion as 50 kilos of dynamite, so that's pretty much. And the good way to think this is the opposite of optimizing engine. On engine you don't want the fuel detonate, you want it to burn, and when it detonates it's the engine knocking. So we try to make like a giant 10 meter cylinder where we have the knocking. And if you know what like engine knocking can do, you get pretty good idea about the possibilities that we have here. And here is the situation after the first day. We got part of the cloud already to detonate. We knew that we are pretty close, so just a couple more tests and we are there. And now we have just built the city, also for the tests, and then explode it away.
kaksi, yksi. Kaksi, yksi.
Puusta lähtee noin vedet irti. Mitä helvettiä?
Heittää vaan siirrepölyä.
Jumaa vittu kun lähtee.
Okay, that was one of the loudest things that I have ever heard. We were really far away and it hits your chest like a good explosion even this far away. But on the high speed you can notice that only part of the cloud really goes, so we still leave a lot of power on the table. And I think our fuel isn't perfect. The explosion doesn't transmit through all the cloud. So we are going to just put more ignition points there. We are going to ignite it from three different points at the same time. And then we can get three times the bang that we now got. And if that works nicely, then Pommisity is going to go. I think this now it's working pretty well.
Kolme, kaksi, yksi. Oi, hyvä päivä! Yes.
Thank you.
Hey, that was exactly the same as nuclear test. The black and white slow motion. Holy shit.
This is crazy.
Flower is down.
Yeah, and casino is down.
Oh no. What the hell? Everything is gone. Whew, I think we have to think about things and film some details here, but I'm really pleased with the end result.
Yeah.
I think this was first of 3 days of work. This is so great. Okay, so the devastation was pretty good, even if we had the device outside of the city, but we wanted to really get that monochrome high speed shot like it turned out. I'm really pleased about that. It was like the whole goal for the project for me was to get that one high-speed clip, and we really made it. And there is also excellent video on Henri's Pommiatka channel. It's in Finnish, but there are subtitles, and there is much more information about the technology and history of the fuel air explosives. And yeah, that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.